In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to optimize your mouse to achieve basically zero mouse input delay, while also getting rid of non-precise inputs and mouse lag. In order to achieve this, we'll be using a multitude of tweaks, some of them being pretty advanced, so there's a high chance you haven't heard of them. But before we get into the video, I want to tell you guys about the EXM Premium Tweaking Utility, an all-in-one tool which can completely optimize your PC for the best possible performance and lowest possible latency. So make sure to check out exmtweaks.com and use our Premium Tweaking Utility to unlock your full potential. Alright, so the first thing that we're going to be doing is making sure that your mouse is plugged into the correct USB port, as using the correct USB port to plug in your mouse has a really big impact on latency. Just press Windows and R and search up MS Info 32 like this, press OK, and in there you will have baseboard product, which for me is a Z790A Pro, and the baseboard manufacturer, which is for me MSI. So you just have to search up your motherboard and manual and you will find something like this. From there, just find the information about the back panel connectors. In there, you simply want to find which USB ports are the highest generation. So on your motherboard, it's probably going to be USB 3.2. And that's where you want to plug in your mouse and other peripherals, such as your keyboard and headset. Just make sure that your mouse and keyboard isn't plugged into any USB 2.0 ports if you have access to better USB ports. Afterwards, if you use a wireless mouse, then make sure that the USB dongle is quite close to your mouse, as if it's far away, it can lead to many issues, especially increased latency. So yeah, it doesn't have to be like exactly right next to your mouse, but just put it near your monitor or something. So the next thing that we're going to be doing is setting your DPI to the correct value, as having a really low DPI can lead to many different drawbacks, such as inaccurate mouse movement and also slightly increased latency. So I left a video in the description explaining all of this. Chose many different benchmarks between most popular DPIs, and I would personally recommend you to use 1600 DPI, as you get pretty much the lowest possible latency and the most accurate movement, while also it not being an incredibly high DPI. So for that, just open your mouse software and set your DPI to 1600, and let's just say you were on 800 DPI before, then just divide your sensitivity by 2, then divide it by 4. So afterwards, you just want to make sure that your report rate or your mouse refresh rate is set to 1000 hertz and more. You can also use the higher refresh rates if you're on Windows 11 and your mouse supports it, but for most PCs which aren't the high end, it will cause stutters and different issues. So I personally would recommend sticking to 2000 or 1000 hertz, but if you have a really high end PC, you can test out the higher values. Then I have another extra tip, which is going to be disabling RGB, as RGB on your mouse and keyboard will lead to additional latency. It's a really small difference, but it counts. There's also other things which you can do in your mouse software, such as adjust the liftoff distance, but it could make a difference for some people. Also, some softwares allow you to change the debounce time of your mouse. If that's the case, then you can change it to one of the lower values, as that will allow you to click faster. So next up, we're going to be disabling mouse acceleration, which you can do by just searching a mouse, and in there go into additional mouse settings. From there, going to pointer options and make sure that enhanced pointer precision is unchecked. If you've been playing video games with it checked, it may take some time to adjust with it disabled, but trust me, it is so worth it, and your aim will overall be much better when you get used to it. You're gonna need to download the resources which were used in this video, and for that you just have to join our Discord server, which is in the description, and the link for it is on screen as well. Just right click on EXM mouse optimization and press download. And while it's downloading, I want to tell you guys something. Please like this video and subscribe, and you will get more guys like this. Anyways, after that, it should show up in the top right corner right here. So just press on it and just unzip the folder, and boom, I'll sort it by name. And then the first thing that we're going to be doing is making a restore point, since this will allow you to revert the tweaks and go back. So for that, you just have to go into the folder and right click EXM restore point menu and run it as administrator. And here, just press 1 followed by enter. It will create a restore point, and boom, after that, you can just exit. If you ever want to use a restore point, you can just go back into the menu and press 2 and enter. So the second step is just going to be some general mouse registry optimizations. So for that, you just have to run all the files as administrator and it will apply. That's everything for this category. Third category is going to be setting your mouse data queue size. All right, so now you just have to run the menu as administrator, and here we have 3 different options, which is high-end, mid-end, and low-end CPU. And the way you find out whichever one of these you should select is by pressing T to open task manager. There, go to performance, and all you have to do is just comment your CPU down below and I'll tell you whichever one of these options you should use. My CPU is a high-end one, so I'm just going to press 1. So afterwards, we have some USB optimization, and that is just going to be disabling some USB power saving features, simple as that. The next step is going to be setting your drivers to high priority. There's a revert for this as well in case you need it. Afterwards, we have setting a new power plan, and this disables certain USB power saving features, which is of course beneficial to the latency of your mouse. So just run the menu as administrator and it will import the free power plan, which is the V7 version. This is a brand new power, which is the V7 version. Don't get me wrong, the free power plan is really good, but I'll still use the premium power plan as it's better. You can just exit out. And here you can delete the default power plans if you want to, which are balanced, power saver, and high performance. They can sometimes automatically switch over, so if you want to prevent that from happening, then you can press 1 to do that. Anyways, I'm just going to be skipping and exiting as I already have them deleted. And next up, we have HeatUsBF, which is a tool which allows you to set the pooling rate of your USB port. So open the folder, and it may look slightly confusing. And first of all, just run whichever amount of hertz you use on your mouse. So I personally right now use 1000 hertz as I don't really play that many games, and I like the extra battery life. After that, run setup.exe as administrator. So in here, just find your mouse, which you can do by simply opening device manager, and in there find mice and other pointing devices, and here. And once you find it, simply make sure set the refresh rate to whichever refresh rate you want to set it to. I'm setting it to 1000. Then select filter on device and press install service. Afterwards, you can just exit out and restart your PC. This will make sure that it applies. By the way, a warning, sometimes it may make it so your mouse or something may not work. In order to fix that, all you have to do is just unplug it, plug it into a different USB port, and then you plug it into the old USB port again. So the last thing is optional, and that is to test your pooling rate variation. And for that, you just have to run mouse tester. In here, put your DPI, which for me is 1600, press start, and do a few big circles around your screen, and then press stop and plot. In here, go into frequency versus time, and I'll just go set this to 1000 and then set this to 5000. I'm gonna be honest, my pooling rate variation isn't the best, as I'm recording this on my testing PC and I've used a lot of experimental mouse tweaks on this to test them, and I haven't really reverted them, which that's my fault for not doing that before the video. If you notice any massive issues here, like for example, your pooling variation is dropping to like 500 consistently, it can have these little dips that doesn't matter that much, but if it has massive drops, then you should be alarmed. There are a few fixes for that. I would try reinstalling your mouse firmware, and in a worst case scenario, I would just reset your PC and redo this guide. But yeah, after that, you can just close the software. This is just a test. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this video helped. Have an amazing day, and make sure to check out exmtweaks.com to completely optimize your PC.